Cardboard Nation, welcome to another episode of Go GTS Live, the Hobbies web show. Hope you guys are doing well, and thanks for taking some time to hang out with us this evening. I'm your host, Rob Bertrand. Joining me, as always, that guy over there, Ivan Lovgren. How are you doing, dude?
I am super hyped today, Rob. It's been a fun week in the hobby already. I'm really happy we get to recap it tonight. It's going to be lots of fun, and I see lots of friends filtering into the chat rooms on Twitch and YouTube, so that's going to be awesome. So, hi, friends.
We got a great show for you guys tonight. We'll kick things off with our Go GTS Live Q of the Week poll question in just a second, but we have Dave Denholm, color analyst for the Los Angeles Football Club, joining us this evening to bust a couple of boxes of top soccer product. We're going to get a firsthand look at the all-new Sport Kings Volume 2 from Sage.
Ooh.
And in honor of NASCAR, we've got a couple of awesome video segments. And then after a few slower weeks in the hobby, we have a super robust hot in the shop segment where we're going to take a look at all the new releases scheduled for next week. And maybe a few surprises along the way. Who knows? But to kick things off, Ivan, the poll question.
Yeah, so the poll is over on Twitter at sort of what we would call our home base. twitter.com/GoGTSLive. It's the pinned tweet up there, so check that out. And vote, because we need you to follow us there also, because later on we're going to do a bunch of giveaways of the hits from these products. We may have some surprise giveaways tonight, but we're going to aggregate our winners from Twitter. So the first key is, hey, follow us on Twitter. And while you're there, take a second to vote in the poll, which is based on the big release this week. I wish I could hold some up and show it to you, of Topps Series 1 Baseball 2021, or as it's affectionately known,
anniversary.
Yeah, flagship. And they kicked it off with a giant, you think our show is massive. They did a massive show, the Topps Series 1 Rip Party on Tuesday. Did you get a chance to watch any of that, Rob?
I did. It was pretty impressive. Emily was
really
awesome.
Yep, she did great. I sent her kudos as well. But because of that, we wanted to know, which rookie do you think is the most chaseable from Topps Series 1? Or who are you going to be chasing? You know, interpret it how you will. And we put three options up there that we thought were the biggest options, along with a choice for other, so that you could respond and correct us when we are wrong. Up there, we put Alec Bohm of the Philadelphia Phillies, who I believe, wasn't he Rookie of the Year last year? We also put, second behind Milwaukee's Devin Williams. We should have put Devin Williams on there, Rob. Dylan Carlson, Joe Adell, or other.
All right.
James was reminding me in my ear that Kyle Lewis was the American League Rookie of the Year, but he did have his rookie card last year, so we're not chasing him. But so far, there's actually a tie. Tie at the top, as you're seeing now on your screen. Alec Bohm and Joe Adell are tied, with other far outpacing Dylan Carlson at 20.9%. Rob, how did you answer?
I answered like several other people in the poll with other. I put any White Sox player, including, of course, Nick Madrigal. I see you, bearded beer guy at Pabst Beer 8. several other of you took the time to weigh in. And Bobby Dalbec. All right. Ryan Mountcastle from Justin Schaefer. David H., a.k.a. Herod D4. On Twitter is saying Luis Patino. So lots of people have some opinions. Zach Veen. You went other too, huh?
Who said that? What?
The Brakes.
I think that was just talking to somebody else about the
Rockies.
Oh, are you
replying to somebody? All right.
Yeah. Zach Veen does not have a rookie card yet, but I think my friend Tom was bemoaning being a Rockies fan.
He doesn't. Okay.
So
which way did you go? Did you vote chalk with somebody on the board or go?
I did go on the board. I've been thinking for quite a while that Alec Bohm is underrated. Okay. Though DX Flyers, who I believe is from Philly, says Bohm buyers are nuts, and I'm a Phillies fan. I may be biased because he's from my hometown of Omaha, Nebraska, but I was always high on him, and then I feel like he got a bit of an unceremonious call-up because of the year, and I feel like people weren't paying as much attention to the rookies last year. So I think he's still a buy. I think he's still exciting. I think he's still a chase. I could be wrong. I often am. But that's what I responded with.
I haven't taken a deep dive into the checklist yet. Are there, besides Nick Madrigal, are there any other White Sox rookies I should be chasing that you know of the top of your head, Ivan?
I don't think so. For the White Sox, I don't think so. If so, there might be a pitcher. Do those count as rookies? I did go through the checklist before I made this, though, so I made sure that I didn't omit somebody that seemed higher. Apparently, Dylan Carlson's not as popular as everybody thinks, but I've been on a Cardinals kick as far as popularity goes lately, because I've just been seeing some interesting things. We were talking before the show about eBay single sales, and I tell you, Cardinals fans are crazy. They love their team. They love their players. So
I thought it's interesting how certain fan bases will like step up to the plate as far as chasing guys and influence, you know, the pricing higher than you might think just based on the fanaticism of a collecting base. I love that. Yeah.
I do see Christopher Jordan said Pache, Gregory Krause said Garcia with the Yankees. Those were guys I did debate. Care Bear also said Pache. So did Donnie Springfield, the Dingo dude. So lots of that. But yeah, it'll be fun. You know, packs are out now. If you can find them at retail, go grab them. If you can find them at your LCS, go grab them. Have some fun ripping. I know that I'm looking forward. I was lucky enough to get a few of the direct boxes from Topps the other day. So I'll be ripping some hopefully soon.
Very cool. Very cool.
FedEx, right?
There you go. Well, we're going to bring on our guest in just a couple of minutes, Dave Denholm, the color analyst for Los Angeles Football Club. He's been responsible for all the Future Watch player profiles of our soccer players on the GoGTS.net blog. So if you are not familiar with our home base at GoGTS.net, be sure to check that out, especially if you're a soccer fan. Tonight, we're going to be breaking 2019-20 Topps Chrome Champions League soccer cards, as well as Topps Museum Collection Bundesliga, the German league.
Yeah, those are a couple of huge boxes, actually, that we're breaking. I think over $1,000 roughly between the two of them.
Yes, yeah. Absolutely.
Yep. And I know in both of them, we're chasing Erling Haaland in the museum collection. We could also hit some cool Giovanni Reyna's if we're chasing the American guys. Topps Chrome, though, also would have Ansu Fati, I believe. Correct me in the chat if I'm wrong. I know you will. I think we're going to get extra strong turnout from our soccer fan friends from Twitter today. I'm actually going to go. I apologize, Twitch. I resubscribed today, but man, the lag is really, really killing it. I'm going to go over to YouTube. So if you're watching on YouTube, I'll be in the chat there following up with you guys. But
awesome.
Is Dave James, with us, or are we still? Okay, gotcha. Cool. I just didn't want to be stalling if he was waiting.
Well, then let's go ahead and switch to the box break camera and bring Dave in when he's ready. How about that? All right. All right, kicking things off, Ivan, we're looking for one chrome autograph card per box, but then there's some color in here that also, in the form of refractors, of the right players could be pretty hot, right?
Yeah, I mean, let's reset. It's 2021. We aren't chasing autos anymore. We are chasing chrome refractors. If we get an autograph on them, that's okay. But yeah, there's six refractors in every box, 18 packs, but each pack only has four cards. And yes, there is that one chrome autographed card. There's also three future stars inserts. and lots of insert sets such as Footballer Flash and Teammate Sensations. But at the end of the day, it's all about chasing numbered parallels in this product.
All right.
Inserts and lots of inserts.
Although I don't think that we would complain about an autographed Erling Haaland if that came in.
End of the day, chasing numbered parallels.
Teammate Sensation, Harry Kane and Sung Hoon Ming.
I do see that Dave is in, but I'm hearing just my own audio coming back.
Boy, Felix.
So if you're a soccer fan and you're watching, jump into the YouTube channel, because that's where I can pay attention to chat. I'm going to need a little help. I do know a lot of the good guys. And there's Dave. He knows quite a few. Dave, you know the good players, right?
A few.
Hey, Dave, welcome back to Go GTS Live. Thanks for helping us out tonight.
Thank you,
Glad you could join us. And I'd like to publicly thank you for all your work on the GoGTS.net blog. Unfortunately, Dave is moving on to other things in his career that are going to take a little bit more of his time. We are going to lose his services. They will be gladly missed, but thank you for the time that you bestowed upon us and for going out with a bang with some breaks. So tell us about Tammy.
Real quick, who is that last card that you put down before the Tammy Abraham? It looked like a BVB player, so I want to make sure it wasn't the one we're supposed to be chasing.
It's Roman Berkey.
Oh, okay. Never mind. Goalkeeper.
We've got a Chrome Refractor Future Stars of Tammy Abraham from Chelsea.
Very nice to be here, guys, by the way. Thank you. I appreciate it. Always fun watching the breaks.
There's someone we know, Mr. Christian Pulisic.
Nice.
A refractor of Kevin Volland. Excuse me. Future stars, Harry Winks.
Young player, still hasn't quite yet broken through, really.
That's a nice gold refractor, numbered 50.
Oh, nice. I love the future stars aspect of it, too. I think it looks cool. I don't know. It's just me, but I do like that parallel.
Yeah, it's been funny that they still haven't really caught on with the, like, the inserts just aren't quite as popular as the base ones, even though I think they look better.
Yeah, I agree with you, Ivan. They catch the eye, certainly. But you're right, just not quite the popularity. And these cards look great, though, I must say.
Angel Correa, Jason Denier, refractor number to 150 of Hugo Lloris.
Goalkeeper, as Ivan would say.
Now, here's the thing about goalkeepers in this sport. What I've been learning is that they actually would carry a premium. Mm-hmm. The problem is there just aren't any, like, there's nobody right now that is a dominant goalkeeper. Is that accurate?
I mean, it's not inaccurate. I think you could argue for a couple, certainly big names at least, that might attract people. In you know, like a Manuel Neuer, one of the best keepers, maybe the best keeper in the world. And he's, you know, a very good keeper. I wouldn't put him as one of the all-time greats yet, however.
But what if it's one as pretty as this?
Oh, that does look nice, I must say. That is a beautiful card, no doubt. I mean, you know, there's a couple other, like Thibaut Courtois, who's well-known, and a couple other guys who have big names. But you're right, Ivan, the position itself right now is not certainly Messi or Ronaldo type of players or anything, even Mbappe. But I do think with soccer, I'm kind of intrigued by it is falling into almost that baseball mentality of you have to score goals. But, you know, there's so much influence on the game from midfielders and even good defenders and wingbacks, you know, guys like Alphonso Davies, who plays now for Bayern Munich, who transferred over from Vancouver, who's been red hot in the card market. He's a wingback, but he gets into the action a lot. You know, there's a lot to how the game is played now it's much more offensive in terms of almost every position on the pitch. So even though you might be listed as a defender, you're actually getting forward a lot and helping out the offense an awful lot too. And so the stats are there for some of those kind of guys.
Oh, how about Harry Kane, just 10?
Ooh, yeah, he's been on fire this year too. He is.
Ivan, I'm sure you're gonna want a picture of that.
Oh, there we go. Yeah, that's not great. Terrible.
But
oh, that's fantastic.
That is a
drop a boom
card.
On that one.
I like
drop
how that's bigger boom. Than what's right behind it is an Mbappe.
A Kylian Mbappe.
Yeah. Oh, by the way, maybe the best player in the world right now, but
yeah.
Oh, that's funny. Awesome.
I've just been amazed. You know, I have to blame you two really for getting me back into cards because now I'm so back into it, so deep. But just a couple, you know, it's been a couple years now, obviously, Rob, since the one time we did this, you and I, that really got me back into it because Rob, without me knowing, sent me some cards just out of the blue after doing it, which really piqued my interest again to get back into it. And so I'll blame you. And Ivan, yeah, Ivan's been at it me with for about the last 10 years almost with this, and I've been really intrigued by it, just getting back into it. I'm a guy who, you know, collected back probably before you guys were even around, basically. But I remember, you know, the dreaded throwing away rookie cards that are now ridiculous in price out there and everything. You know, when I was a kid, we were, you know, still trading them for next to nothing at times. So I appreciate you two getting me back into it, and with an emphasis on soccer now, which I'm, these are some great cards. That number to 10, though, is, yeah, that is a boom.
What was the, I just saw a Tammy Abraham that, because I'm unfortunately, I have to watch on YouTube to see it. What was that one numbered to?
It was not numbered. That purple Tammy Abraham purple.
It's just that it's too small for my screenshot, so I'm watching on YouTube.
It looks like it should be numbered.
No. Don't worry about it. It's just a small
thing. All right. Our Otto, tell us about Roberto Firmino.
Well, certainly a great player for an awesome team in Liverpool, which is highly, highly popular club around the world. Popular clubs here now, and he's certainly a huge part of their attack. That's a great card there. There's a lot of Liverpool fans, in the United States as well, but they're all over the world. One of the most popular teams. So if you're going to get an auto from a club, it might as well be Liverpool. That's a great pull there. And Roberto Firmino, the Brazilian international, just a fantastic player, certainly. Maybe Liverpool players, in a way, they kind of share the spotlight on that club in a lot of ways. Now, they're very popular, Mo Salah, Sadio Mane, Firmino, who you just pulled. But they do share a lot of the limelight, too. Wow, this is a great pack already. Holy cow. Mbappe, and then...
Lionel Messi, refractor.
He's pretty good.
hold that for another second there.
Oh, that's beautiful.
Very cool.
Not a bad player there either. Yeah.
Yeah, and I'm looking up those Firminos and
here we go again. Future stars, Trent Alexander-Arnold for Liverpool. Still a young player. I mean, really young, but obviously, you know, an English international as well. They're very popular within the sport in terms of collecting. So that's another good pull with that future star. But Ivan mentioned some of them right before I got on. Ivan, you were pretty spot on.
Well, I mean, obviously it was Holland.
I've been very impressed.
Yeah. And
Christian Pulisic green refractor.
Wow. This is a good box. This is a good box.
This is a Christian Pulisic box, it appears too, yeah.
Gareth Bale.
So, I looked up that Firmino, and it's about a $200 auto.
Wow.
Lots of sales at $200 on that.
The one we just pulled?
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, they're calling, someone called him the defensive striker, which goes along with what you were saying, Dave, about.
Yeah, everybody puts in work around the pitch. Abdou Diallo is a good talent. Still has a little ways to go in terms of really being recognized by a lot lot of people yet, and it's certainly in cards. He is a defender, so I don't know what that. You know, that's what Thibaut Courtois was mentioning as well. The goalkeeper, a very, very, very good player. These are some. This is obviously a loaded product anyway, because it's the Champions League. So, Serge Gnabry has had a good year too. Bayern Munich actually just won the World Championship. You know, we always talk about the World Series and the NBA being the World Champions, but they actually had the final game of the Club World Championship today, and Bayern Munich defeated Tigres of Mexico to win that. So, Luis Suarez has been, he actually has moved on to Atletico Madrid. He's been absolutely sizzling to start the year. Always a good player, though.
This card's unique. It's a noticeably thicker card stock.
Wow.
It's definitely shiny and colorful, but doesn't have any numbering.
Wow.
Sal
Atletico. He's been such a good player for a number of years. One of my favorites, actually, for Atletico.
All right, two packs left.
One of the top teams in La Liga. Oh, João Félix, huge card there. Tammy Abraham again. This is a good. These guys are young and talented for sure.
Purple numbered to 150 of Ederson.
Ederson, good goalkeeper there, Man City.
And last pack.
Yeah, I know you say that's a stacked product because of the league, but I've seen some stinkers. This box is definitely not a stinker.
Yeah, I mean, in fairness, yeah, the Champions League certainly has teams from all over Europe, so some of them are not the top, you know, echelon necessarily. But
how about Ederson Green, numbered to 99?
Goalkeeper's dream box here.
There you go.
All right, we have lots of fun stuff to give away in addition to the auto. So we're going to obviously give away the Harry Kane number to 10 to one winner. Another winner will get that auto. And then somebody's going to make out with the rest of the color.
Wow.
What? Oh, wow. So three winners total, one getting
an... You mentioned it, Rob. I apologize, Ivan. I'm unable now to, you know, continue writing with the future watches. Does that mean I'm eligible to win? Because I want to enter the... I'm going to leave the conversation.
Yeah, you wish.
Pardon me, Ivan. I apologize.
No, you're fine. You're fine. Awesome. So three winners total, right, Rob?
Oh. Yes, three winners total. Yep. And
one of them is going to make out like a bandit. So are the other two.
With an SRP right now of about $700 for that box, and some people's first reaction is, wait a minute. But you look at, you know, the fun that was, all the regular refractors and base set off to the side. We pull a Harry Kane numbered to 10. We have a Harry Winks numbered to 50. Hugo Lloris numbered to 150, a Lionel Messi refractor, Christian Pulisic green parallel refractor.
Yeah, so the Messi refractor alone, just base non-numbered, is $50.
Mm-hmm. See, so, wow, somebody is really going to make out with this little stack. So enjoy that. Enjoy that, whoever the winner is.
A Harry Kane gold, which is numbered to 50. Oh, that's from a different year, though. Looks like one sold for around 100 of the gold numbered to 50.
Wow.
Yeah. So comps are pretty insane on this. And that was a pretty great freaking box considering we didn't hit Erling Haaland or Ansu Fati. So,
right.
So I already tweeted it out. A lot of you probably already know the drill. So you've gone there, but remember at the top of the show, we said, go GTS Live on Twitter is where you want to be. We'll go there right now, and you will see that we just tweeted out the tweet to enter to win. So make sure you're following us, and make sure you retweet that tweet in order to enter to win.
Thank you, Ivan. Next up, we have Topps Museum Collection of the Bundesliga League. This box guarantees an autograph card, an autograph memorabilia card, and a memorabilia card. So this is a higher end product. Current SRP about $300.
And the Bundesliga, we've talked about it before, one of the top leagues in the world, certainly. The Champions League encompasses all of Europe, the best teams of each league, but the Bundesliga is one of the best leagues itself. Certainly loaded with talent, Erling Haaland being maybe the biggest, Gio Reyna, as you guys discussed earlier as well. Those are some packs there. Wow.
All right. Suleiman Abdullahi. Yes.
Beautiful.
Even the base cards are thick. Oh. Super shiny.
Wow.
Joshua Kimmich.
Had a goal called back today. It was a great shot, but one of his teammates was offside. He's a great young player for Bayern Munich. Maybe the best team in the world.
Leon Bailey. Bailey.
He is an awesome talent. Really underrated talent. I happened to cover the Bundesliga for years for Fox, and he was always one of my favorite young players at the time.
Mm.
Simon
Tarota.
Tarota, okay. All right, our first hits are coming up. We've got a parallel. It's a keeper. It's numbered to just 25. It's Leopold Zingerli, 20 of 25. Our memorabilia card.
Paderborn, is
it? Numbered to just 50.
There
Josh
is
Sargent.
Oh, what a great card. Yeah,
and it's numbered to just 50, yes.
I think he's a great talent. To me, he's a guy who's still proving himself a little bit, but with the U.S., he can make a big splash in the upcoming World Cup if he has a good tournament. Werder Bremen is the team he plays for. They're a decent team, but he's still kind of just making his way in the Bundesliga. I love that card, though.
Beautiful. Our autograph. Archival autograph of Daniel Ginzik, numbered to just 75.
Interesting auto.
And anything you know about him?
Ginzik, I mean, he's a young talent. He's not a huge name. Not a lot of people would be familiar with him in terms of just maybe an average collector or an average soccer fan. Doesn't play for one of the top teams. I mean, Wolfsburg's a legendary team, but they're not dominant at this point by any means.
Gotcha.
And last but not least, Raphael, auto jersey swatch, numbered to just 75.
He's been around for a long time. Just scores goals all the time. He's a great player. That's a beautiful autograph, too, on that one.
Awesome. So three giveaways from this one. Obviously, this card. I'll pair the auto up with the parallel number to 25, and then the jumbo kit swatch of Josh Sargent, numbered to 50.
Awesome. I'm getting that tweet put up right now. Dave, sad to hear that you're moving on, but also happy for you that you're getting even better opportunities. Still in the sports world?
Yes, I'm just adding some more responsibilities with LAFC in terms of, content and stuff. So as we get ready, season's going to start. They just announced it on April 17th. It'll begin. So it was just probably the right time to kind of get going before the season here. I got a couple of months that I have to do to get prepared and get some of this other content rolling. But I do appreciate everybody involved in this show. And Rob, of course, you're a great guy. I appreciate it. It's been nothing but fun. And you've always been good to me. I do appreciate it. And I love that, you give soccer an opportunity as well, which is great. And
absolutely.
It's been a good time. It really has. And, I love James. He's great. Whenever I've done these shows with you guys, and even doing one with Rob a few years ago, like I said, that really got me back into collecting and following you guys and watching the show and everything. I really appreciate it. Again, sometimes I'm a little mad about it, but other times I love it. And you two are the key ingredients to that, of course. And we know, you know, Ivan, you and I have been talking about this. You really got me going back into it many years ago, and I appreciate all that you guys have both done for me in terms of the, you know, collecting and getting me back there. So appreciate it.
It's absolutely our pleasure. Again, thanks for your tenure here. Best of luck to you in your new endeavors. And all of us get to say someday, hey, I knew that guy when.
When LAFC
Yankees. No, you do not. Yeah, it's fun. It's already going to be our fourth season. I can't believe it, quite frankly. It's gone. It's flying by. Obviously, we hope to get back to maybe a little bit more normalcy coming up, hopefully at least later in this season. But yeah, it's been a really great ride, and I love working for LAFC almost as much as I love working for you guys. So thank you very much. I appreciate it.
Awesome. Well, it was good seeing you again. Thanks for hanging out with us this evening, and we'll talk to you soon.
You bet. Thanks.
All righty. Bye-bye. Dave Denholm, class act. So happy that we were able to have his expertise around for as long as we did. So, yeah, when you guys are pulling cards and you see a player you may not recognize, we might have a player profile for that young talent, as Dave so often refers to them. So be sure to check out GoGTS.net, Future Watch Soccer.
That's awesome.
You okay there? That was fun, right? That was quite the ride.
Yeah, it was. And I just took a second. I just jumped on the Twitter and I see like David Panopoulos, the real D-Pan, says, can't we just open more and more soccer tonight? And it's funny because honestly, I started collecting soccer about 3 years ago because I was already getting priced out of some of the other sports. That was also when I didn't have a whole lot of money because the kids were being born. Diapers.
Yeah, funny how that happens.
And LAFC was just starting off, as Dave mentioned, 4 years old now. This is their fourth season. So I started following it a little bit then. And honestly, I don't know what it's a sport that is so much fun to open product from. It's really fun for me. Now, it may not be for you, but I encourage you, anytime you're starting to deal with feeling like, oh, the hobby's overpriced or the hits or everything, go back and find a product, a sport, and just open a box for fun. That's how I feel when I open soccer. It's just more fulfilling for me than opening anything else. So,
interesting. You heard it here. I love it. All right, let's shift gears. We've got a lot to talk about in this week's edition of Hobby Happenings, where we dive deep and give hot takes on all of the news, notes, and nuggets happening from around the hobby. I'm going to close my email so I don't get any more interruptions. All right, kicking things off. Well, trading is officially open on the Collectible app. The new feature allows existing shareholders to sell their shares acquired during an IPO to other collectors, and in turn provides those collectors interested in purchasing shares of a previous IPO that were not able to do so upon release, a way to do so now. It's really much more simple than I probably explained it, but you can visit Collectible app for more details.
Well, it's finally happened. Long talked about, finally here. Michael Jordan has officially joined the $1 million card club. But get this, not with that famous rookie card. Nope, it's with the 1997-98 Upper Deck jersey autograph that we talked about last week in this space that was up for bid at Heritage Auctions. The sale went into extended bidding after our show ended, and when the gavel finally dropped, this card sold for an eye-popping $1.44 million. Buy a new home.
Made up for lost time, I think.
Yeah. MJ did.
The complete artist roster for Topps' all-new Project 70 has been released and includes several notable artists. Topps hoping to maintain the momentum from last year's highly successful Project 2020 with this all-new direct-to-consumer offering. You can visit tops.com for more information. Have you, has it been time to dive into that at all, Ivan? Project 70?
They have not released any individual cards yet. Yeah. But if you want to try to do a panel with some of the artists, some of them are returning from Project 2020, and I happen to be connected to a few of the new ones too. So maybe we could put that together. It might be a fun round robin when it kicks off.
Cool.
Looking good. Snoop Dogg, right? That's who you want.
Yep.
Get Snoop Dogg on the show. This past Tuesday, Topps hosted the 2021 Series 1 Rip Party in honor of the 70th anniversary of Topps baseball cards. Emily Kless from Topps and the entire team did an amazing job to celebrate the momentous occasion, interacting with tons of special guests, celebrities, athletes, and many more over the course of the three-hour event. Keith Olbermann, as is tradition, opened the first pack of Topps baseball cards for the 2021 collecting season. Other guests on the three-hour-long rip party included Mark McGwire, Ryne Sandberg, and Mariano Rivera, just to name a few. The event also included the first ever Breakers showcase that pitted Bomber Breaks, Leighton Sports Cards, Mojo Break, and Real Breaks in a competition-style breaking event. After three rounds, it was our friends at Mojo Break that won the coveted Platinum Box Cutter. Hats off to all involved for a great way to get the baseball season and the baseball card season started.
Nicely done, Topps. Super Bowl 55 turned out to be a rather lopsided showdown between the reigning Super Bowl champion Kansas City Chiefs and the NFC champion Tampa Bay Buccaneers, led by
refs.
After all the passes were thrown on Sunday, it was the Bucs who prevailed in a 31-9 shellacking behind the arm strength and leadership of now seven-time Super Bowl champion quarterback Tom Brady. Well, before any snap was taken from center, the battle against fraudulent Super Bowl 55 game used memorabilia was already well underway thanks to PSA. You see, behind the scenes in its ongoing efforts to combat fraudulent sports memorabilia and counterfeiters, professional sports authenticator, PSA, tagged with synthetic DNA ink each of the footballs that were scheduled to be used during the Super Bowl 55, as well as the official two-tone coin that was used in the pregame coin toss. PSA President Steve Sloan said, "It's always our distinct pleasure to team with the NFL to ensure the authenticity of each of these game-used items. Our proprietary technology allows us to stay far ahead of the counterfeiters." Nicely done.
Baseball, baseball cards, and beer. We don't know what this means just yet, but count us in.
Yeah, more details to follow. Apparently on the rip party, there was a tiny little announcement. More details to follow. eBay released its 2021 State of Trading Cards report, which spotlights collecting trends as well as some industry predictions. The trading card category on eBay grew 142% in 2020, with over 4 million more cards sold on eBay than in 2019. Wow. Leading this growth was soccer sales, which increased an astronomical 1,586%. A major contributor to this growth was absolutely explosive interest from overseas, with trading card sales to Australia and China seeing huge spikes year over year. There were several high-profile sales on the platform as well, a few of which exceeded $500,000.
Yeah, going back to the story before, the record for the year, I believe, was Tom Brady at 556,000 for one of his contenders' autographed rookies.
Yep, right there on the screen. So, number one.
Crazy. This year's list of SPs and SSPs in Panini Contenders NFL football cards has been posted on the Panini Company blog in two separate parts. There are several notable players with print runs as low as 25. Be sure to check out the Lance Knight, the Knight's Lance for more details.
Absolutely. And that's a look at this week's hobby happenings. Were you able to catch any of the Tops event, even for just a few minutes?
Yeah, I watched almost all of it. Had a lot of fun. I really enjoyed Ryan Sandberg. His was kind of fun because he said a lot of stories about the guys he worked with. Mariano Rivera was also very cool because his was live. So it was very like, you know, some of the others were edited. So even though I enjoyed them, it was like, you know, had a package feel to it. Sure. Mariano Rivera was just live and off the cuff. And he just seems like a really humble guy for being a Hall of Famer.
Very cool. Well, we have a second box break segment this evening.
Oh,
and if you remember, you were thoroughly, thoroughly impressed with Volume 1. Sport Kings is an iconic name that goes back to the 1930s. The license has been handled by multiple manufacturers over the years, most recently by Sage Collectibles. And this is their Volume 2. This is the hobby version. There are also blaster versions, just like last year. But in the hobby version, we're looking for two hard-signed autograph cards, one game-worn swatch card, three limited edition base cards, and a bonus insert in every box. Yeah. Bonus card inserts could include Century Heroes cut signature, one-of-one sketch card, a Jared Kelly, love Jared Kelly, one of one hand-painted art card, a Paul Madden base card rendering, a grand patch card, or another hard-signed autograph or swatch card. I love that they put a partial checklist on the box.
Yeah, I'm pretty excited for this. I've seen a few breaks already and some really good hits, it looks like, coming out of it. So it's fun for us to be able to preview it. You know, it's part of the show. Obviously, everybody's aware of the rip party for Tops. It's not a huge surprise, even though it's news. But did you know that this was out here? This beautiful art-based set with some, you know, great true relics and true autographs in it. So let's check it out.
Drew Brees base card, nicely done. True to the style. Color palette. Leah Pruitt. She's a racer. She's a drag racer.
Wow.
With the Forces. The Force family. All right. How about that Ted Simmons patch?
Hall of Famer.
Three color patch there. Beautiful.
And from the Baby Blues.
And on-card auto of bike racing champion Chris Froome.
Let me grab the front of that one again. Oh. Nice, good. 25% of the card is the auto.
Colo Andino. He's a surfer. You get one mini in every box. Stephen LeBeau. Boom! 1/5. Roger Staubach on card auto.
There we go. Hall of Famer.
Wow. 1/5.
Absolute legend in Dallas, still active and keeping the league strong. I don't know if you saw before the Super Bowl when they were telling Drew Pearson that he finally made it in the Hall of Fame. Oh, no. It was Staubach and Jerry Jones were in the room waiting to give him the news. It was a touching moment. So, wow, 1/5, Roger Staubach from Sports Kings.
So what I'm going to do is I'm going to have three winners with this one. The Roger Staubach, the two other autos, and then the beautiful Ted Simmons Hall of Famer triple swatch patch or triple color patch. So three.
Real quick, who's so there was Chris Fromm, and then who was the other one from
Stephen LeBeau, some sort of medalist. I need more bio on the back.
Stephen,
I know someone who could do that. Extreme diving champion.
Extreme diving.
Won the 2017 World Championship held in Budapest.
So he's an American.
Crazy cliff divers.
Yeah, he's part of the Red Bull cliff diving team. So see, that's what's so super cool. Didn't even know that's a thing. Now I'm going to spend the rest of the show reading about it and phoning it in. Wait, no. Oh, David Reel's watching. I got to pay attention. That was for you, David, if you're still watching. But yeah, pretty freaking awesome. Going to have some research to do after that. But when it says Red Bull and cliff diving, you know you want to learn more.
You know that means good.
Yeah. So awesome. So we'll have three winners of that. Thank you to Sage for getting that to us. And make sure you check out your hobby shop or favorite online retailer for some of that if you want to get some of that artistic, vintagey, and off-the-wall type autograph potential. Looking good.
I might have to take a deeper dive into that. I love all that off-ball stuff too.
Yeah, well, you know what, Rob? We have a website for you to do just that. If you go to gogts.net, you can pull up all the information there is on this product, including, you know, you mentioned half the checklist is on the back of the box. Well, you can preview that by going to gogts.net and just searching for Sage Sports Kings.
Awesome. We are going to update the poll question, and you guys are awesome. We've more than doubled the number of votes from when the show started. And Joe Adell is starting to pull away a little bit, 35.6% over Alex Baum at 32%. And others still leading the way over Dylan Carlson, 18.7 to 13.6. And tons of replies and retweets to that. A lot of people continuing to weigh in. Thank you. Poll will be open for a little bit longer. Also remember, tag us with Go GTS Live QA. And we will, later in the program, answer one of your questions. Use the hashtag GoGTSLiveQ&A so we can find that real quick.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Shoot us a question on Twitter so that we can have our interactive segment in like 20 minutes. So do that right now as you go retweet the Sport King tweet.
This weekend is a big weekend in NASCAR with the Daytona 500.
The super, diddly do.
Yeah. And Gray Galding had a conversation with Panini about all the happenings. Check out this video, and we'll be right back to take a look at next week's new releases in Hot in the Shop.
So tell me about that with the Panini, because I just did a trading card signing for them some months ago, and the guys hooked me up over there. So tell me a little bit about the partnership you got going on with them.
Yeah, man. No, that's cool. No, Panini has just been such a great partner. You know, 2 years ago, we kicked off our relationship. It was kind of crazy, you know, just a spur of the moment. We didn't have anybody on the car at Bristol, and my dad got in touch with Jason, obviously from Panini, and the relationship just built from there, more not just business, but, you know, me and Jason, I mean, I remember at Bristol, like we were RVing at the racetrack, playing cornhole. Like we were able to give Jason the full effect of NASCAR the way we do it. You know, we're not like the big teams, you know, we're kind of the bulldozers. We get out, we work, and we have to kind of work for everything. But just so thankful and fortunate for Panini. You know, they gave me an opportunity actually at the end of 2019 during the summertime. I told Jason and everybody at Panini, I was like, hey, I need an engine for Talladega. And if we get this engine, I know I can give myself a chance to win. And we lost by 6 feet, finished second, you know, got a lot of TV time. So like I said, it's amazing brand to be a part of. You know, now we're in our third year together, and this time we're full time. I got a full time ride again. And it's just, I don't know. It's just like a fresh start. You know, last year was a tough year, obviously, for everybody, all of us, you know. So to break in the new year, having my Panini colors and having, you know, wearing this shirt loud and proud to go to Daytona. So we're excited for another season together.
So me just being how I am in my personality, I can't wait to see things get extremely aggressive. Last stretch.
The funniest part is I tell people all the time, it's like, you know, we might run, especially Daytona. Daytona is the worst. I think it's actually worse than Talladega. Because, you know, Daytona is a little bit, it's a lot tighter than Talladega is wide. Like, when we're four wide, that's easy. But when you're 3-4 wide at Daytona, I mean, we're talking, I could reach out and touch the guy next to me. Like, you know, it's tight. But I swear, every year, when the spotter says 10 laps to go, all of us drivers, we just take our helmets off. We throw our brains right out the door. It's just, I mean, the moves we're making, I'm just thinking, there's still 10 laps to go. And then, I mean, I can't say much because I'm just as bad as any of them. But, you know, hey, when it gets down to the nitty gritty, you know, we're talking Daytona here. I wrecked my mom to win at Daytona. I mean, there's a lot of history there. So trust me, the aggression is going to be at an all-time high when it gets about 10 laps to go. But I'm excited about it. Hey, I'm getting chills thinking about it.
You telling me, I'm sitting there getting hyped up myself and also pissed off because I'm not going to make it this year. But hey, great, man. Good luck down there. Come out clean. And if you got to get a little, you know, aggressive towards the end of that thing to pull it out, man, go ahead and do your thing.
You got it, brother. Hey, man, thanks for having me on, man. I really appreciate your time.
You got it, man. Thank you. Appreciate you.
Panini America has been a partner with yours for the last couple of years between Cup Series races at Rick Ware, as well as part-time endeavors in the past. To have them on board for a few races, for what we know now, multiple races heading into the 2021 season, what's that partnership been like from your perspective?
Oh, it's been unbelievable. You know, I can't sit here and say, you know, I don't really know where my career would be. I wouldn't quit working and quit fighting. But, you know, without Panini, I really don't know where my career would be. They almost, I mean, I put them in the category of almost saving my career. We all know this sport, you know, takes sponsors and takes partners. But when you got partners like Panini that really, you know, we have that relationship outside of the brand, in which I love the brand to death. I can relate to it. Avid card collector my whole life. The synergies were there from the get-go, but it's just about who they are as a company and the individuals that take care of everything. Is I've just been so pleased and blessed to know them, know their families, and represent their brand on a daily basis. You know, when I wear this shirt and I wear that suit, I wear it with pride, because the product that Panini puts out, and I feel the product that I put out, you know, as a representation of NASCAR, Panini, you know, I really want to be a good role model. And I think with us being paired up again for 3 straight years and them sticking by me when, you know, my career was kind of a roller coaster, they stuck by me. And honestly, there's no other sponsor and partner I'd rather have on my shirt, on my car, than Panini, because they've really done so much for not only myself, but my career going forward.
All right. So that was pretty cool. Well done, Panini. And thank you, Panini. How about a bonus giveaway in honor
of
Gray Golding? How about a box of Don Ross NASCAR?
You guys.
From this year, 2021. And how cool is this? I mean, if you have to wear a mask, why not make it a Panini Color Blast mask?
I love that. Make it awesome. Make it represent sports. Make it represent collecting. Good idea. Though I did see a little good news, Rob. I don't know if you saw my tweet earlier today.
No.
So President Joe Biden is claiming that there should be 300 million vaccines delivered in America by the end of July. And that does matter to me, because one of my biggest events every year is the National Sports Collectors Convention. And that tells me that I may have a comfort level of attending, because I may be able to actually get a vaccination by then. So fingers crossed that what that means for us in the hobby is that the National can go off with very little hitches this year. I think that would be incredible.
Amen to that. I hope so, regardless of what happens. All right, let's dive into next week's new releases. Sure to be hot at your local hobby shop, online retailer, or your favorite group breaker. Remember, all release dates could change at a moment's notice, but we're pretty sure this is the lineup. Kicking things off with 2020. Notice that. Topps Dynasty Formula One racing cars. Yeah, our cards. There was a delay and then another delay and then another delay, but we are so happy to be getting our first look at the brand new licensee Topps with Dynasty Formula One. You're going to get one premium encased autographed memorabilia card numbered to 10 or less in every box. Absolutely incredible. The first ever premium Formula One racing card product gets the full Dynasty treatment with an assortment of highly collectible autograph relic cards, such as Dynasty autograph suit zipper relics, Dynasty constructor team dual autographed relics, and Dynasty triple autograph relics from all F1 drivers and team principals. And if you watch Drive to Survive on Netflix like Ivan and I do, you know those team principal autographs are in some ways maybe even cooler than some of the driver autographs. Oh, so for well, sure. Well done, Topps. Just a little bit more. All Dynasty autograph patch cards numbered to 10 or less. There are parallels numbered to 5 and gold 1 of 1s. I highly encourage you to check out some of the There's three images. It wasn't even worth putting a video together. But as you can see from the sell sheet here that James is showing you, the cards look gorgeous. Supposed to be in stores next week.
If you have Netflix, spend the next few days. I have not introduced it to anybody who does not binge it instantly. Drive to Survive. It is captivating. It's better than Hard Knocks. It's better than any other sport live documentary. The drama is so real, and it's an easy sport to follow because there's only roughly, 20 drivers. So
yeah.
So check it out. Pretty excited for Topps bringing that to collectors. All right. Well, next up this week, we've got from the Gridiron 2020 Panini Limited NFL football cards, 3 packs and 5 cards per pack. So decent, not just hits focused, but each box is going to deliver 1 rookie patch autograph card or 1 Ring of Honor autograph card, plus an additional autograph card, a memorabilia card, and a parallel. So this is going to have on-card rookie patch autographs of the super hyped 2020 NFL draft class. If you don't know about those guys yet, I don't know if we're going to be able to help you much. But yes, Joe Burrow, Justin Herbert, Tua Tagovailoa, as well as Jordan Love, Jalen Hurts, very deep class. Justin Jefferson has been flying off the shelves. So all of that and plenty more. But look at some of these things like rookie phenoms, oversized swatches. Very cool looking there. Booklets in this product, like that partnership's dual booklet right there. And even the base cards have a nice bit of elegance to them. So check out Panini Limited in hobby shops and online this week.
And finally, we put a cap on the 2019-20 NHL collecting season with the always highly anticipated super premium, the Cup from Upper Deck. Each tin is going to deliver 2 autographed patch cards, and some of them are the most sought after high-end rookie cards of the year, defining the super premium collecting experience hockey fans have come to know and love. The Cup returns with new drool-worthy content. Brand new this year, bolstered autograph patch card lineup, array of new inserts highlighted by new wave or rookie auto patch tribute cards from the 2014, 15, 17, 18 season. And those are all numbered to 10. More big time booklet cards, lots of big patch auto cards, and of course, exquisite hits. Find exquisite rookie patch auto cards numbered to the jersey number of each featured player. Search for the elusive 1 of 1 exquisite rookie auto shield and much more next week in the Cup.
Next up, we've got an exciting basketball product. Yep. More jerseys on rookies in 2020-2021 Panini certified NBA basketball cards. So yes, Hoops is already in the rearview mirror. Time to look at certified, which delivers one rookie autograph card per box.
Yep.
Ooh, gotta love that.
Yeah.
Makes the chase a lot easier. Plus one additional autograph card, plus 10 parallels and 8 inserts or insert parallels. So lots of fun stuff to chase in this. Of course, it's all about, look at that, those 2020 mirror greens, gold team mirror blacks, the mighty mirror gold. So certified's got all these awesome different mirror parallels and inserts. The mighty ones that you saw there, those are one of the bigger chase cards from this. Parallels, it goes on and on and on. But again, big news is rookies in their jerseys, great autographs, lots of cool stuff to collect here. So look for that with hobby shops and breakers this next week.
And some baseball coming your way in the form of Leaf Lumber Kings for 2021. Leaf Lumber Kings delivers 4 premium game used bat cards in every box. Is a unique product focusing on players' primary tool of the trade, the long revered and celebrated baseball bat. So, absolutely loaded with themed inserts and some legendary players. So, game used lumber, Mickey Mantle, Willie Mays, Duke Snyder, 3000 Hit Club, Pete Rose, George Brett, Derek Jeter. Monster Mash, a single player back card featuring sluggers that have hit the longest home runs. Ruth, Mickey, Mantle, and Willie Stargell. Fall Classic, a 6-player back card featuring participants in some of baseball's most glorious World Series. Yeah, like the 75 Red Machine or the 86 Mets. How about Midsummer Classic? Nostalgia rules in these 8-way player bat cards, or Bat Rack Trios, a 3-player bat card. So you can have a swatch of bat from Matthews, Killebrew, Snyder, or Mantle, Trout, and Mays. And look, I love how the die cuts look like bats on the Bat Rack 3 card. And then you up the ante with the cool quad cards. I think that's a great way to display a bat swatch. Fall Classics, as we talked about. Fun stuff there. Absolutely loaded. Mount Crushmore, like I said, tons of themed inserts. And yeah, those are the right guys on there. Nameplates, Duke Snyder as an example. That's a coveted piece of lumber right there. A dual bat nameplates, Henderson and Tim Raines, you kidding me? And guys like Mays and McCovey. Ooh. Yeah. This sell sheet was so fun to read through. And of course, yes, bat knobs, 101 bat knobs. Look at that. Bat knob MVP, Ronald Acuna Jr. Mickey wow. Mantle with the mirrors authentication right on the knob. I love that. Yeah. Check it out. Get in a group break of that. You'll have fun.
Hey, that's not all from Leaf this week. Leaf also has some baseball cards hitting, pure baseball cards. No bats here, but plenty of pop. That's right. Leaf Flash Baseball Cards is coming out with 6 autographed cards in every box. And this features not only an incredibly attractive design, not only some great veterans and prospects, but it also showcases top picks from the 2020 Major League Baseball draft, including Spencer Torkelson, Heston Kjerstad, Bayron Laura, and many, many more. Of course, collectors have been hot for months on to years for some of these other names, Wander Franco, Jason Dominguez, Fernando Tatis Jr., 6 autographs per box, lots of low numbered parallels, and of course, one of ones on that shiny, flashy Leaf Flash design. So check that out this week.
And we've got even more baseball, this time in the form of 2021 Break King Baseball Premium Edition. Break King is a premium buyback company distributed by Leaf. They deliver this product in particular, delivers three premium buyback cards, including at least two graded cards in every box. Look for a variety of modern premium cards of the game's best players, all cards being from their rookie year, which is great. All the cards from rookie or prospect year, excuse me, featuring MLB's top players, including guys like Luis Robert, Fernando Tatis Jr., Bryce Harper, Clayton Kershaw, and many more. All currently active players and all cards, again, are from products released in the player's rookie season. Break King will sure to be popping at your favorite online group breaker as well.
Rob, we've got a pretty cool Star Wars product coming out this week. Top Star Wars Signature Series trading cards. So if you're familiar with some of the archive signatures and those things from other sports, this is a one-card box, which is going to feature over 100 different signers on collectible autograph card variations from your favorite characters from the entire Star Wars saga. So you see some of the names there. Quite a few different Han Solo autographs in this. Daisy Ridley as Rey featured multiple times. Darth Vader, Emperor Palpatine, you know, spans the gamut. There's more than 100 autographs, as mentioned, and tons of parallels. However, unlike other Signature Series, these are not buyback cards. They are their own brand. So check it out in hobby shops this week.
And last but not least, it seems like a little while since we have had the opportunity to look at a Marvel trading card product. But after some delays, Marvel Ages Trading Cards is due out next week. It's going to deliver four base set foil parallel cards, eight photo variant base cards, two decade cards, and a flavorful or word cloud card in every box. So a lot of different eclectic content going on. Old school 300 card clay coat stock set. Marvel Ages provides a new retrospective that looks back at Marvel Comics since their founding over 80 years ago. So recall the iconic eras of Marvel Comics from the Golden Age to the present day in trading cards. I'm down. All right. So you're going to get a base set sticker parallel card in every pack and two inserts in every pack. Those inserts could be Saturday morning cartoons, Totally Toys, Gameverse, and Artist Spotlight. Super cool. Box hits, we kind of went over. Foil parallels, photo variant base cards, word cloud, decade cards. So those are all inserts. And then you've got some case hits. One to two artist sketch cards per case. One to two coinage or comic clipping cards. So coins and comics, original comic clipping cards. Three Fresnel cards. Wait till you see those. And 10 lenticular puzzle backs. So technology meets history meets comic creations and all from the Marvel brand. Upper Deck's been doing a bang-up job with their Marvel products. This should be no different, like that Totally Toys. And there are some of those coinage cards that we told you about as well. We'll let this play out because it's certainly worth looking at. But this will be in stores next week as well. So let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 products scheduled for release. That could change tomorrow at a moment's notice, but right now that's what's on the docket. And looking to be
fingers crossed the Dynasty
in the shop. Absolutely.
Don't push Dynasty any further.
All right. We have to put Ivan to work to pull the winners for tonight's giveaways. But before you do, I was actually invited on a Zoom call with NASCAR driver, Rookie of the Year, Cole Custer, this week. And I put, with permission from Jason, thank you, at Panini, put together this little clip. So watch this. Ivan will get put to work, and we'll be back to announce the winners, do Go GTS live Q&A answer, and do the prize wrap-up and get you guys out of here.
Hey, welcome. Everyone, glad to see you all here. Excited for Daytona here this weekend coming up. We finally got some NASCAR races back. Happy to have Cole Custer joining us today. Obviously had a phenomenal year last year and what was a really crazy year. Congratulations, Cole, on your Rookie of the Year.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
Next up, why don't we go with Rob Bertrand.
Hey, Cole, thanks for taking the time to do this. Can you talk a little bit about what the impact has been having Panini America as a licensee? You know, from an insider perspective, with, you know, them sponsoring a car and Greg Golding and the job that they've been doing with trading cards, what impact has that made on the overall audience for NASCAR? And what do the drivers think of Panini's involvement in the sport?
Well, I think what you've seen, I mean, like you said, I mean, they're involved in almost every aspect of our sport, you know, from sponsoring on the car to doing, you know, deals with drivers, you know, I think they're involved in every single part of it. And it's brought a lot of fan engagement into it. You know, obviously you have a lot of collectors and trading cards from all kinds of sports. So then you add NASCAR into it, it brings you into a whole different kind of category where you can, relate to those people who collect trading cards. So it's just something that's, I think they've done a great job with, and they've been able to connect with a lot of fans through it, and they've been able to, you know, touch every single part of our sport.
Thanks. Great answer, and good luck this weekend.
Thank you.
Yeah, I know, that's definitely one of the things we at Panini miss is we love to see you guys racing around the track, but man, we can't wait until we get fans back in the stands just to, you know, interact with them and have you guys interact with them. You know, that's such a great experience, there at the track. You know, last year with the pandemic, you know, audibling to this format has been really cool because I feel like this has created like a good level of intimacy and, you know, connection to the fans. But and we'll be glad when we get fans in the stands again, for sure.
How's it going?
Good. I was just curious. I collect a lot of diecast. So I was just curious, do you have your own diecast collection? Do you collect your own stuff? I mean, I know your first one just came out, so.
Yeah, I've been collecting stuff since I was a little kid, you know, diecast cars. You know, I have a bunch of Jeff Gordon cars. I have a Dale Earnhardt car. I think I even have my teammate Kevin Harvick's cars. So, I think it's just something cool, you know, that's kind of different about our sport that you can, you know, collect a lot of different kind of cars and cards and, you know, whatever it is. So, I've definitely been into it since, you know, I was really young.
Hey, Cole, how you doing?
Doing great. Thanks for coming on.
You're welcome. I got a question for you. what is your favorite Panini NASCAR product?
For me, I always like the Prism cards. I think those things are really cool. I mean, just because of the style of them, you know, they're always have really sleek and really shiny, and I think they kind of pop more. But also, I think the cards where you get like material in there, like whether it's the suit or the shoe or whatever it is, you know, I think kind of brings like a personal touch into it, and I think those ones are really awesome. Also,
all right, thanks, Cole. And my birthday is February 13th, and good luck in Speed Weeks.
Well, happy birthday! Thank you.
You're welcome.
Yeah, sorry about that, Cole. Thanks for your time this morning. I totally appreciate it. But I was curious, what was it like the first time you saw yourself on a trading card when you actually held one and were looking at you, thinking to yourself, "Oh, I've made it. I'm on a card."
Yeah, that was a weird experience. I mean, for me, you know, I used to collect, you know, trading cards and hero cards and stuff like that when I was a little kid. And to be on one and kind of to see myself and my bio on the back and stuff like that, it was kind of like, you know, I couldn't really believe it. And, you know, it didn't really feel, you know, real almost. So, you know, to see even now, I mean, it's still kind of crazy to think about how you're kind of, you know, people are walking up to you to get your autograph where I was that kid when I was a little kid. So it's just still, I mean, it's kind of something you have to pinch yourself every day.
That's fabulous. What a great answer. I appreciate that. And good luck this weekend. Good luck this entire season. Thanks for your time.
Thank you.
Tracy from Panini, I'm going to let you jump in on some good, fun, light questions and maybe some trading card questions too.
For sure. Hopefully all those. Cole, thank you again for doing this. It's a pleasure to see you again, talk to you from the cozy confines of your driver's seat. One of the things I noticed going through the entries, especially on your Twitter, when you posted about this Q&A, one of the things I noticed I thought was interesting was that a few people showed their favorite Cole Custer card, but then they said, I'm about to trade this away. And so I wanted to know what your thoughts were on kind of being traded like a commodity, or your card being traded like a commodity, and kind of what that meant that you have obviously enough value that people not only want your card, but are willing to trade it to get something in return.
Yeah, that's something I honestly, you know, you bring to my mind. I mean, you know, you always think about signing and people are wanting you sign cards and you're able to see the cards and stuff like that. But you don't really think about how they're, you know, being traded and how you're actually, you know, part of that whole world. And for me, I mean, it's just unreal. I mean, you know, you think of yourself as a little kid, I mean, growing up trying to do this, and you don't ever believe that you're going to eventually be in the spot where people are wanting your trading card, you know? So I think it's just unreal. I mean, to think about that kind of aspect of it, and it's still something you kind of have to pinch yourself.
Nice job, Rob. Hey,
thanks.
What's that?
I've got another box of Donruss NASCAR Racing to give away and another Color Blast Panini face mask. So thank you to Panini for inviting me on. That was fun. And as you could see,
I look away for 2 minutes and the boxes multiply.
Cole was a great interview and very receptive to doing that, and had lots of good things to talk about collecting related. So that was really cool. Before we list the prize winners, we did get a Go GTS Live Q&A question from
nice.
AZCom. With Hoops Basic Hobby Boxes going for ridiculous amounts of money, what's going to be the best affordable cards for kids to buy to get into the hobby? Oh, are we going down this road, really? okay, well, we can start with Donruss Racing.
Yeah. What are those priced at right now?
Not very expensive, $75.
So here's
20-something packs, 24 packs in there. How about NBA stickers, where they also have the cards in the thing? How about Topps Baseball? Series one. How about, well, wait a minute. Ivan, you were telling me something that was pretty interesting.
Well, I was, but I'm actually thinking differently about it now. This is what 2 minutes on ice will do to you. Because I think that the reason the question triggered me at first, I'll be honest, AZCom, it triggered me a little, is because of the fact that it's comparing hoops to it. So I guess the question really is, are you asking the hobby or are you asking basketball? Because basketball, yeah, you're pretty much stuck with what Rob just mentioned, which is, you know, well, actually, no, you're not, though, because Hoops releases at retail, doesn't it?
Yeah, of course.
Doesn't it, Rob? And I don't know if you've seen this, but there has been limits set in place by lots of retail establishments, you know, since we've last talked about it. I've seen tons of this. Target's only letting people grab two. Walmart's only letting people grab two. Applying that to two total from the entire thing. So one, I think that retail is still accessible, which is what was always created as an avenue for kids. But two, if you go outside of basketball, yeah, there's a lot of great options. You know, heck, Topps Baseball was available on the website for a couple of hours. It sold out because of a glitch, but then it was back available. So I just think that it's just, there's a new way to get cards. And last year we were killed by the bots, but the market and the botting, like they are sort of coming together a little
Absolutely.
Bit to yep. where bots don't want to be stuck with 10 pallets of top series one. So I don't know. I think there's a lot of hope. I think you can't look at a retail sticker price. I mean, Panini actually sold them for $350 first off. So that's half the price.
Yep.
But the other thing that it's supposed to be a 10 second response segment. The other thing that does get me also about this question is, I know that if you follow me on social media, you know, I live in Los Angeles. It's a high cost of living city. You know, obviously people have to make a little more money to live here. I did not come from this. When I was a kid, I was opening triple play, collector's choice. I would walk to the Hy-Vee grocery store and I had a quarter to buy Donruss. I could not afford Upper Deck. In fact, just the last national, I opened a pack of 1989 Upper Deck with Pack Geek, a good friend of ours, and I realized how little of the cards I recognized versus 1991 Fleer, because I was never able to open them. So I don't know that set like I do others. So for me, this has always been a thing where it's like a hobby box. I could never imagine opening that as a kid. So I don't understand why now so many of us that are adults apply that back. Oh, my kid can't open a hobby box of hoops. I don't feel as much empathy as I probably should. So I may be the wrong guy to ask. But that said, I also firmly believe there are ways to get cards. Heck, watch this show. We're giving away two boxes tonight, you know? So I think that there's a ton of new avenues that are created by the demand that give me a lot of hope. And I'll finish my rant now with this, is that, again, I said, hopefully there is a national this year. Hopefully we're all feeling comfortable to attend. You know, it's looking like that might be the case, which would be great for all of us to be able to see each other again. I guarantee you, you would be shocked at how many kids roam the halls of that event if it happens and when it happens, how many kids are collecting. We just don't see it, maybe because we're on social media, and a lot of kids don't get on social media until they're 16 or 17 or 18, which is often right when they're falling out of the hobby to go, you know, study, school, sports, cars.
Ivan, I do think you brought up a good point when we were off air talking about this question, though. It was a 14-year-old kid who flipped that Giannis NT card.
Yes.
From 40,000 to 1. Whatever thousand or $1 million. So
1.8 million.
I'm not saying that every kid has access to that kind of capital, but you know, obviously there's different price points for everybody.
I could go off on this a little, and I hate it because AZCom's a great follower, a great viewer of the show. It's nothing personal against you. It's probably just that I get hit on with this quite a bit about people tugging at heartstrings, that sometimes it gets boiled over a little bit with me. Guess who's running the bots?
Kids.
It's not me and you. We don't have bots. I don't know how to. I've been trying to buy this one type of cryptocurrency for 3 weeks. I had to call three different friends and say, how do I transfer from this wallet to that? You know, it is kids, you know. Yep. So and actually, Rob,
I'm cutting you off.
This is so important, though, Rob. I had a friend who is a flipper. A friend who's a flipper just today on Twitter posted, you know what? When I saw that box of 1991 Jump Wax, it made me go search, and I'm going to buy this Blair Thomas card, even though it's worth nothing. So many people get into the hobby for flipping, and it's contagious. It is the hobby. You know, and there is a thing where you make enough money flipping and all of a sudden you're like, you know what? Hey, I can afford that $50 PC card. It's not a waste having it just sit on my desk because I made $300. Wow, I just bought that $50 card. Maybe I'll buy this box. Flipping leads to collecting. It is a contagious hobby. So that's another reason why I don't necessarily have a problem with the current environment, because I know a lot of these flippers, yeah, they see dollar signs the first month or two, but guess what? They get hooked too. They become passionate collectors. They're watching the show right now, some of them. So I love you all. Buy your kids Donruss Racing.
There you go. You heard it from Ivan. Hey, want to give a quick shout out to our friend Tony Todd, who's watching tonight, along with first-time viewer Milo. Welcome, guys. Thanks for tuning in.
Tony Todd, who made our Best of 2020 clip segment.
That's right. That was awesome. Yeah. All right, let's put a bow on this puppy. We've got some prizes to give away, several cards and two boxes.
I just let it all out. I'm ready. Here's the fun part. So if you guys can't get cards at hobby prices, watch Go GTS Live. We've got 11 winners tonight, two of whom are getting an entire box. Plenty of others who are getting some awesome stuff. So, great. Well, thank you. Remember, the way you entered was retweeting and following us on Twitter. Make sure you engage on off days too. If you're a Twitch subscriber, We do special giveaways for Twitch subscribers, and you can subscribe for free with Amazon Prime or for $5 a month if you don't have Amazon Prime. Tonight, if you hear your name called, and by name I mean Twitter name, because I don't know exactly your full name, BroncoFan247365, email us at gogtslive@gogts.net. It's easy. It's the name of the show at the name of the website that you can use for those checklists and product information. So email us there with your name, your full mailing address. This is 2021. We still have to send it via carrier. Your Twitter handle and what you want. Real easy. The information we have, the information we need. We pair it up. Rob ships it out. Huge thanks to Rob. And you will get your cards or your boxes or your packages. So the first one, I already spoiled the beans. BroncoFan247365. You won all of the color from that UCL Champions League Topps Chrome box that we were ranting and raving about. I hope that you are also a soccer fan and can enjoy it. If not, I know you can find lots of soccer fans to share that with. It's going to be awesome. But there was a premier hit from that, from the Premier League. See what I did? Harry Kane, numbered to 10. That's going to @BN9700. Congratulations. Next up, then, we have the autograph from that, the Firmino Auto. Awesome auto. Longtime fan, longtime player. That's going to BrownsFan221. Congratulations, BrownsFan221. Switching up, but still on the pitch, to Bundesliga Museum Collection. We have the Josh Sargent, the American relic card. That's going to MetJetFan55. Congratulations, MetJetFan55. We've got the Daniel Ginza auto. That is going to Current A Fear. Congratulations. And then we have the Raphael soccer auto. That is going to Chai's Party 07. Congratulations, Chai's Party 07, on the Raphael soccer auto from Bundesliga Museum Collection. Hey, speaking of museum, like, Sport Kings was awesome. Had some great throwbacks, including a triple swatch of Hall of Famer Ted Simmons. Look at that. That's a good display card right there. That's going to Hunter Julius 4. Congratulations, Hunter Julius 4. Next up, the two autos, Chris Fromm and my new favorite, Stephen LeBeau, cliff diver from Florida. That is going to Chrissy Buccino. Congratulations, Chrissy Buccino, on the Chris Fromm and Stephen LeBeau autographs from Sport Kings. And then the Roger Staubach auto, numbered to 5, is going to Tom P. Willis. Congratulations, Tom. Roger Staubach auto for your collection. Cheers, man. Next up, we've got bonus giveaway 1. Donruss NASCAR racing box plus a great mask to wear to come see us at the National. That's going to Hippie Dan, Hippie with 2 eyes. Not sure if it's still Hippie or if it's high Hippie. Hippie Dan, congratulations. And then bonus box number 2, same thing, NASCAR racing plus a mask, is going to Chef M. Smith 04. Congratulations, Chef M. Smith 04. Awesome. Have I been canceled yet, Rob? I haven't checked comments yet. I asked if I'd been canceled yet.
Nope, you're good. Thank you for wrapping that up. Special thanks to Dave Denholm for sitting in and helping us navigate our way through the Bundesliga and Champions League. Thanks to Emily Kless for sending us some product to look at. Chris Stratton at Sage with Sport Kings, as well as Tracy Hackler and Scott Prusha for the Zoom call and providing prizing in the form of Donruss NASCAR racing cards for this evening.
Rob, I got to just jump in real quick.
Yeah. Please.
So they saved my rant by actually talking about what the first pack of cards they bought was in the chat. And I think we need to bring that up next week and talk about that in more depth. That's a fun topic from what I'm reading in the comments.
All right.
What's awesome. Your first pack of cards? Hit us on Twitter with that, actually. Tweet us after the show with your first pack of cards to keep the conversation going, because that's a fun conversation there.
Absolutely. Well, thank you to James Gale behind the scenes, making us all look good. Ivan Lovgren and GTS Distribution. Thank you all for watching. Obviously, the show is for you. If you don't watch, why are we doing it? So thanks for all being here. And we will be back next week with a brand new episode of Go GTS Live, the Hobbies web show. In the meantime, you know what to be doing. Always be collecting and have a great weekend. Good night, everybody.